In this lecture, we will study about the angular kinematic of human movements, measuring angles, angular kinematic relationship between the linear and angular motion, linear and angular displacement, velocity and acceleration. So first of all, we should know about axis of rotation. Anterior-posterior axis is known as frontal plane, rotatory plane. In which we study about anterior and posterior side and mediolateral sagittal plane, left and right, longitudinal up and down is transverse plane, such as shown in the figure.
Oftentimes the body is sectioned or cut along a surface or plane, which is referred to as a body plane, birth planes. When a section of the body or organ is cut, it's named after the plane which it occurs. There are three major body planes: sagittal planes, coronal or frontal planes, and transverse planes. Sagittal planes run from the top of the body to the bottom and run from the front to the back. So sagittal planes divide the body into left and right sections. If a sagittal plane runs down the midline of the body and divides it into equal halves, it's called a mid-sagittal plane. Coronal or frontal planes run side to side and top to bottom. These planes divide the body into anterior and posterior sections. Transverse planes run side to side and front to back. These planes divide the body into upper and lower sections. These planes are sometimes called horizontal planes. Since we have an infinite number of possible planes and ways to draw planes, any plane that is not a sagittal, coronal, or transverse plane is described as an oblique plane. So we can draw a plane like this, which goes side to side, but also runs slightly up and down and slightly front to back. This is an oblique plane. And that be the basic.
So next is observing the angular kinematic of human movement. Gear rotational analysis at hip, knee and ankle. How much kinematic are important even to kinetic human movement? Coaches, teachers and clinicians routinely analyze the human movement based on visual observation of range of motion. For the human body, joint center for the vertices of body segment angle. Relative angle. Angle at a joint formed between the longitudinal axis of adjacent body segment. Relative angle should constantly be measured on the same side of a given joint. The straight fully extended position at a joint is regarded as 0 degree. Absolute angle is the angle orientation of a body segment with respect to a fixed line of reference. It should be a fixed line of reference, whereas in relative angle, adjacent body segment. Absolute angle should be constantly be measured in the same direction from a single reference, either horizontal or a vertical. Relative angle measured at a joint are angle between the adjacent body segment, and absolute angle are the angle that are made with respect to fixed position. Tool for measuring a body angle is goniometer, part of goniometer are fulcrum, stationary arm, movable arm, placement of the goniometer and measuring angle, instant center of rotation. The center of rotation at a given joint angle or at a given instant in a time during a dynamic movement is called instant center. This phenomenon is caused by a normal asymmetric in the shape of articulating bone surfaces. May be determined through the measurement taken from roentgenograms, x-rays, which are usually taken at 10 degree interval through the range of motion at a joint. The path of instant center at a knee during a knee extension. Angular kinematic relationship. Interrelationship of angular quantities are similar to that of linear quantities. Unit of measurement are different than their linear counterpart. Angular displaced distance and displacement. Consider a pendulum swinging back and forth from a point of support. The pendulum is rotating around the axis passing through its point of support perpendicular to the plane of motion. If the pendulum swings through an arc of 60 degrees, it has swung through an angle distance of 60 degrees. If the pendulum then swings back through 60 degrees, through its original position, it has traveled an angular distance totaling 60 plus 60, which is equal to 120. Angular distance is measured as the sum of all the angular changes undergone by a rotating body. The path of motion swinging pendulum B, the angular distance is the sum of all the angular changes that have occurred. The angular displacement is the angle between initial and final position. angular distance, the same procedure may be used for quantifying the angular distance through which the segment of the human body move if the angle at the elbow joint changes from 90 to 160 during the flexion phase of the forearm curl exercise. The angular distance covered is 70 degrees. 160 minus 90, 70 degrees. If the extension phase of the curl returns the elbow to its original position of 90 degree, an additional 70 have been covered, resulting in the total angular displacement of 70 plus 90, 140 for the complete curl. If 10 curls are performed, then the angular distance transcribed at elbow will be 70 multiplied by 140 multiplied by 10 is equal to 1400. So just as with its linear counterpart, angular displacement is assessed as the difference in the initial and final position of the moving body. If the angle at the knee of the sport leg changes from 5 degree to 12 degree during its initial sport phase of running stride, the angular distance and the angular displacement at the knee are 7 degree. 12 minus 5, 7 degree. If the extension occurs at the knee, returning to the original 5 degree position, angular distance totals 14, 7 plus multiplied by 7. But angular displacement is 0 because it returned towards its original position. If it covered a distance of 7 plus 14, but in angular displacement it is 0 as displacement is the shortest distance. So when there is no distance, it returns to its original position. So displacement is 0 because the final position of the object is the same as original position. Angular displacement, changes in angular position or orientation of a line segment. The clockwise direction is regarded as positive and clockwise direction is regarded as negative. Counterclockwise direction as a positive and clockwise direction is as a negative. Unit of angular distance and displacement. Degrees, the most familiar of these unit is the degree. The complete circle of rotation transcribed an arc of 360 degrees. An arc of 180 degrees subtends a straight line of 90 degrees from a right angle between the perpendicular line. Second unit is radian, unit of angular measure used in angular linear kinematic quantity. It is equal to 57.31. Radian is equal to 57.3. The radian is defined as the size of the angle subtended at the center of the circle by an arc equal to the length of the radius of the circle. One complete circle is an arc of 2 pi radian or 360, because 360 divided by 2 pi is 57.31. Radian is equivalent to 57.3. We will discuss it as this is a whole circle. It is this radius and 2 radius. So it is equal to the arc of 2 pi. 1 radius is equal to pi 1. So it is 2 pi or 360. It whole will be 360. Whole angle will be of 360, but 1 will be 180, 1 will be of 180. Oh, 1 minute. Okay, 1 will be of 180. 1 will be of 180 and 2 will be of 360. So whole circle will be a 360 and we will divide it into 2, will be equal to 180. So 360 divided by 2, 180, not 180, 2 on the 2, 2 on the 2, 2 8 the 16, 0, 180, 180 into degrees, which is equal to 57.3 will be answer. So if we clear all of this, then okay, we have read all of these. Angular distance, displacement. Okay, we are here. Okay, then next is pi is a mathematical constant equal to approximately 3.14, which is the ratio of the circumference to the diameter of the circus. circumference to the diameter of the circle. 2 pi r into d. So definition, third unit, one unit definition describes an arc equal to a circle divides the sum. Dice and some gymnastic skills are often to be referred as revolution. Next is angular velocity. Change in the angular position divided by change in the time will be equal to angular velocity represented by W omega. Angular position delta divided by delta time is equal to angular velocity, which is delta t, theta over delta t. The lowercase Greek letter omega represent the angular velocity. The capital letter theta represent angular displacement. T represent the time elapsed during the velocity assessment. Another way to express in angular position is angular position 2, angular position 1. Minus kar denge, in which angular position 1 represent the body position at one point in time and angular position 2 represent the body position at two point. So angular position 2 minus angular position 1 is equal to time 2 minus time 1. It will be change in the angular velocity. Angular acceleration is the rate of change in the angular velocity or the change in the angular velocity occurring over a given time. The conventional symbol for angular acceleration and for lowercase letter will be alpha. Angular acceleration is the change in the angular velocity divided by change in the time. Alpha is equal to delta omega delta t. And similarly, like the angular velocity, rate of change of displacement, and then rate of change of velocity in angular acceleration. T2 minus T1, this formula of W1 represents angular velocity at initial point in the time, W2 represent the angular velocity at second or final point in time, and T1 and T2 are the time at which velocities are accessed. You know the formula is linear is represented in meters, velocity meter second, acceleration meter second square, and angular meter. In angular meter is converted to radian, radian second or radian second square. Just as with the linear acceleration, angular acceleration may be positive, negative, or zero. When angular acceleration is zero, angular velocity is constant, just as the linear acceleration. Positive angular acceleration may indicate either increasing angular velocity in the positive direction or decreasing angular velocity in the negative direction. Similarly, a negative value of angular acceleration may represent either decreasing angular velocity in the positive direction or increasing angular velocity in the negative direction, either acceleration or deceleration. Unit of angular acceleration is velocity divided by unit of time. Common examples are degree per second, radian per second, revolution per minute. If you have any questions, you will tell me. Thank you so much. We'll meet in the next video. Jazakallahu khair.